In this video, how to make a super easy and super cute 8-page mini book from one single piece of paper. Welcome to the I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you are art inclined, love painting tutorials, art journal ideas, and art hacks, you're in the right place. I want to thank Meri from the Meri Atelier for organizing this collaboration. The topic of this month is going to be to make mini art journals or miniature books. So everyone in the hop, which is called Fourth Sunday Hop, is going to be working on mini books. Okay, so the one I'm going to be doing, and I'm going to make several of it, is going to be one made of one single piece of paper. It can be the printer paper that you have in there, or it can be decorated pattern scratchbook paper from this type of pattern paper books. Let me show you. I piled up everything in here that I was going to be using. Anyway, these books are awesome because they have all kinds of beautiful patterns and colors and everything. And this one in particular is thin paper, so it makes it a lot easier to work with. But let me put this back over here. Also, you can use a grocery paper bag, like the typical just paper bag. I'm going to start working with this one. And what you do is, with an X-Acto knife or a kitchen knife or whatever you want to use to cut them, you're going to go into the side of the bag like this, and you cut all the side of the bag and then the bottom. If this is the opening of the bag, you cut the bottom and then around and then on the other side, and this side is open, so you're done. And I cut mine before I started recording this video. And then you cut exactly the other side the same way. Move the bottom of the bag like this. Cut around it just the same. The sides and the bottom of the bag. And you end up with the sides of the paper bag. And this is for another project, because I don't like wasting such a cool paper. If you like wrinkled paper, like I do, with a lot of texture, this was previously all just smashed and wrinkled, but it's pretty much a single side of the grocery paper bag. What we're going to do, I'm going to demonstrate with this little paper that I made also to check on for the paper with patterns, printed patterns, what to do with it. So basically, you have your piece of paper. This is from a notebook, so literally any paper is a good paper. We are going to fold it with the pattern outside in your not pattern, your blank side inside, or the pattern that you don't like so much, because sometimes the paper comes with two prints. So the print that you like goes outside. You fold it like this, and then you fold it again and mark it very well. If you have one of those bone paper things, you can just go with it, or with your scissors or whatever, the nail, whatever you can use. And make sure that the corners are very well pointed, like corner to corner. And then you do another fold. Once you have it well marked, you unfold it again And with the opening of the paper to the top and the folded side closer to you, you will go with your scissors and cut from the folded part to the center. Then you unfold it, fold it on this other direction, and join it like an accordion type, like this. And then fold the other parts like so. And what you have is the pattern outside and a few pages of your beautiful paper with your beautiful pattern or texture, like you will see in a minute. Really cool. And what I want to say that is different from other tutorials is that if you are into ATCs or ACEO cards, then you will see that on one side of your folds, you have two openings, like this and like this. Or, depending on your pattern, you can turn it the other way and you will have more openings, pretty much everything. See, this one over here is an opening as well. And the last page is also another probable opening, like a little pouch, a little envelope to put things. Depending on the side of your paper is if you can tuck in the ACEO just natural like this. But in some, like for example this other one, where we can use the double-sided tape, you will have less space, but that doesn't mean you cannot just stick in there some type of cool thing, like a tag or something, whatever little thing that you want, a little picture or stickers, or maybe, hey, money, if it is like a little cool gift card, book type of card, you can stick in there a gift card or money or a check or whatever. You and your creativity decide what to put in there. If it fits in there, it can go in there. Now, I have a paper punch, and I, in the past, in another video that I can link in the information box below, I punched a little circle like this so you can access easy the card or the little tag or whatever thing that you put inside, but that's totally optional. And for an example only, let's say that you want to close this over here, that you want to just go with the two openings in here, because your pattern, for example, this other one over here that I made, this, it would look kind of bad if I put it upside down to have more openings, more little kind of pouchy spaces. So this one has to be like this because of the design going in this direction. But you still have a space to put something even longer, because this is the square paper from this other book, which is, I believe, like 12 by 12, I think. I don't know, but it's larger than the printer paper. So it gives you like a rectangle, and it is beautiful paper. You can just paint or collage something, or just leave it like that and put some little quotes, whatever you want. It's just beautiful. And in this case, I would just totally use only one or two of the ones that are still open, and I would close mostly the first one so you can make sure that it's completely closed. So we're going to be doing that. I just want to make sure that it's not too long. And we put it in the very corner, And now it doesn't want to come out. Okay. Oh my gosh. Is he going to do this? Well, in a perfect world, this would act up correctly. And if you're watching the replay, just ignore this part where the tape is not behaving. Anyway, I don't want to waste more time battling with this thing. Let's just pretend that this thing is taped and that I was able to remove this easily, which is not helping, but that would make the page, the cover, be completely sealed. Another solution could be just use your regular glue medium and just seal them close so you can just open them just like a regular book. Also had another thing that I wanted to show you. I'm not even going to bother with the double tape anymore. But I also thought of having something cute hanging from it. And the best way that I could think of is to protect the paper, use a little bit of washi tape in a color that makes sense to the paper that you're using. Let's say that I want the word love, and I'm going to put it kind of in the corner because it's mostly just to protect the paper from the next step, which is going to be making a little cut. And to do this cut, I will use my other cutter for support. So in the part where it folds, you make just a little cut that goes all the way to the other side, to the outside. And with a paper clip, or if you have one of those needles, like furniture big needles, you can bring it in and punch the paper. But for now, what I'm going to be doing is just literally making the paper cut, push the, if it lets me, because apparently it's not going to, push the yarn or whatever pretty ribbon that you might have through it. Like this. And then you have a little more color for your little booklet, your little mini book. And it is super easy to make. Okay. Now, for the other, let me move all of these to the side. For this larger size of paper, I'm going to move also this heavy pattern paper. Okay, we're going to do the same thing. We have our paper, we fold it as much as we can, corner to corner, matching very well. And then we put it again in another fold over here. And then one more fold. Since this paper is completely wrinkled, and the whole point of this is that it's so full of texture, I don't mind that the corners might not be exactly matching, but I think it looks really cool. So we unfold the paper, and then we're going to cut. I kind of wanted to cut with my hands just to have more edgy, shreddy edges, but it will take me forever. So we open the paper again, fold it opposite side, and then gather our corners. I think I need to cut a little bit more. Okay, we gather like this, make our folds again. Because of so many wrinkles, it's kind of not wanting to fold correctly, but I think in this particular case it's part of the charm that it is all old looking, all torn, wrinkly, and cool. So to fix this one, we could use gesso or dry brushing a bunch of colors. If you wet it, the wrinkles are going to kind of be more kind of leathery. If you add medium, it's going to also look more like leather, and it might take the paint completely different. If you use very wet paint, the broken corners of every little wrinkle are going to catch more paint than the little parts that are unwrinkled, the parts that are not creased, and it's going to look like a very old document. More watery is going to go into the creases and make him more intense. So for now, I'm just going to put it on the side and work on the other papers that I have here with more pattern. And it's just easy once you kind of get the idea. I cut this one into the size of the printer paper, but it's the same 12 by 12. And this particular pattern doesn't have up or down, so it doesn't matter what size, side I mean. What side you want to open it from, because the leaves can go in any direction. So you have your paper, your folded part towards you, then cut all the way to the corner of this folded part, and you turn it this way, make it like an accordion, and then let the folds go to one side or the other, whatever is easier on your folds. And you have another little booklet. You seal the corners. That's my preference. But if you want it open, or if you're using just regular white paper, whatever happened to my other paper here, if you're just using a regular white paper, so you do your own sketches and your own art in a blank paper, it won't matter, because even after you're done on the regular 8 pages that you have for doing your art, you can still fold it in another direction, inside out, and use those as well to keep painting. Like if you're going for a day trip and you want to have just little easy, more manageable folded paper instead of having the whole flappy, flowy sheet of paper, you can have this folded little mini book and you can stick it in your pocket, or you can just easily just grab your pencil and do your thing. But if you have more time to do a dedicated sitting session for doing your art, and also if you like the idea of sticking something in the little openings of here of each page, you can have your ACEOs or any of a variety of things that you can think of. The ribbon idea is also fun to make. I'm just going to make one cute last one with the paper. If this is the first time that you visit this channel, remember to subscribe if you like art journals and art and acrylic painting. And right now, if you're in the live, you can see the link to click for the next person in the hop. So click on there. If you are in the replay, then check in the information down below to see the link. And thanks for visiting. I'm kind of rushing to finish this one. And then you're going to see on this hub bunch of different type of mini journals, mini art books, mini junk books, miniature, little gorgeous tiny books. I will have all of them in here. Since I couldn't finish this one, I'm going to have a different video of showing you how to finish just a paper, grocery paper bag, little mini book. And for now, all I have to say is thanks for visiting and have fun in the hop.